Today I am starting new chapter, linear inequalities. You have learned linear equalities. This is linear inequality. So difference between linear equality and a linear inequality. It is that if I keep any equation like this, so this is said to be linear equality. And if I relate this linear part with sign of inequality, here if I insert sign of inequality greater than 0, or if I give less than 0 or less than or equal to 0, so these are said to be linear inequalities. Now, to understand this topic, before explaining the methods in this topic, let us understand few basic rules. So here I give two numbers. Suppose 2 is less than 5. 2 is less than 5. So if I multiply this number by any negative, suppose I multiply by minus 3. So multiplying this by minus 3, this will be minus 6, this will be minus 15. Now observe relation between these two numbers. See, here relation is reversed. Here 2 is smaller than 5, but now what happens? Minus 6 is greater than minus 15 is true. So whenever any inequality, it is multiplied by negative number, then this relation will be changed. It will be reversed. Suppose I take minus 3. Minus 3 is greater than minus 10. This is true. Now if I multiply this number, multiply by minus 5. If I multiply by minus 5, then what will happen? Minus 3 into minus 5 is 15. Minus 10 into minus 5 is 15. Now check relation. This is reversed. So see here. What is change in relation? If you observe this in this statements. So that means in general we can say that for statement 1, for xy any real number and xy, this is xy, and this number I am calling small a, which is negative, and a is negative, x less than y implies multiplying this by a x a y, so this relation will be reversed. Whenever you multiply by negative, relation will be reversed. But if I multiply this by plus 3, if I multiply by plus 3, this will be plus 6, this will be plus 15, then this relation remains unchanged. If you multiply this by plus 5, then minus 10 into 5, minus 15, minus 10 into 5, minus 15, then this relation remains unchanged. See, greater than minus 3, greater than minus 10, minus 15 greater than minus 15. 2 less than 5, 6 less than 15. So relation remains unchanged. Relation remains unchanged if you multiply any inequality by positive number. So second statement, for any xy belonging to R and E is positive, this number I am saying E, this is E, E is positive, x less than y, E positive, x less than y implies multiplying this by E, Ex, Ey, this relation remains unchanged. If you multiply inequality by positive, if you multiply inequality by negative, this relation will be reversed. Same statement, similarly we can state for E less than 0, and if statement is x less than or equal to y, less than or equal to, and if you multiply by negative, Ex, Ey, these numbers are multiplied by negative, so this will be reversed. And for xy belonging to R and E positive, x less than or equal to y implies multiplying this by positive, Ex, Ey, so this will remain unchanged. So whenever we will work with inequalities, keep remember this point. Suppose here we have x less than y plus 5. Now I want to multiply this y 3. So if I multiply by 3, so 3 is positive, both sides multiply by 3. So because multiply by positive, inequality remains unchanged. And if this inequality I multiply by minus 2, suppose minus 2x, here minus 2y, minus 10, minus 2 is negative, so this will be reversed. So that will be the application of these rules. And you can understand well by such examples. We have, suppose minus 3 is less than 10, that is true, minus 3 is less than 10. If you change sign on both sides, changing sign on both sides sign is changed, that means what is done? This inequality is multiplied by minus 1. This is multiplied by minus 1, this is multiplied by minus 1. So because multiplying by minus 1, this will be changed. So wherever we will change the sign of every term in given inequality, relation will be changed. So changing sign, that means it is nothing but multiplied by minus 1. If I multiply, suppose, now I am doing on this inequality. If this inequality I multiply by minus 3, multiply by minus 3, so this will be minus 9. Multiply by minus 3, this will be 30. Both sides multiplied by minus 3, negative number is multiplied, and now see, this becomes smaller. So whenever you multiply by negative number, relation will be unchanged. So we shall use these rules in this chapter. Then one more point. Suppose 2 is less than 5. 2 is less than 5. Both are positive numbers. Now I am taking the reciprocal. Taking reciprocal, 1 by 2, 1 by 5. Now check relation. Which is smaller? See, 1 by 5, this is 5th part and this is half. So fifth part is smaller. Relation is reversed. Both are positive numbers. Taking reciprocal, relation is changed. Suppose I take here minus 2, minus 5. Now these are negative. Minus 2 is more than minus 5. Minus 2 is more than minus 5. That means minus 5 is less than minus 2. Same statement. Minus 5 is smaller than minus 2. Now I am taking a reciprocal. Minus 1 by 5. Minus 1 by 5. So this is minus 0.5. This is minus 0.2. This is greater. So relation is change. And suppose I take minus 2 less than 5. 1 negative, 1 positive. Now if I take reciprocal, taking reciprocal, relation remains unchanged. This remains unchanged. See, both positive, taking reciprocal, relation is changed. Both negative, taking reciprocal, relation is change. Left side negative, right side positive. Relation remains unchanged. So from these three examples, now I am writing here three statements. This was for both numbers more than zero. This was for both numbers less than zero. So first of all, for this statement, if x and y both are positive, if x and y both are positive and x less than y both are positive, if both positive, taking reciprocal, the relation will be changed. If you take here less than or equal to, here it will be less than or equal to. Same statements for strictly less than, same statements for less than or equal to. Similarly, for this statement, both are negative. If x and y are negative, x and y are negative, and then x less than y implies 1 upon x greater than 1 upon 1, or x less than or equal to y implies 1 upon x greater than or equal to 1 upon y. So it was false such statement. And here sign of inequality remains unchanged. So if x is negative and y is positive, then x negative, y positive, so x less than y, negative is smaller than positive, but then taking reciprocal, this is negative, reciprocal of negative is negative, reciprocal of positive is positive. So this will be negative, this will be positive, so this relation remains unchanged. So whenever working with equations, equality, suppose x equal to y, so whenever you work with equations in class 9 or class 10, multiplying such equations by 3, you continue sign of equality, multiplying by 3, or if you multiply by minus 2, if you this number multiply by minus 2, so this will be minus 6x minus 6y, then we make zero. No change in sign, no change in this relation. When relation of equality is given. But now in this chapter, if you are given x less than y, you multiply this by 3. So relation remains same. Now if you multiply by this minus 2, so this relation will be reversed. So sometimes relation will be reversed. Sometimes it remains same. When taking the reciprocal or multiplying by positive or negative. So this is the basic to solve problems in this chapter. Now here I am explaining method to solve linear inequalities in single variable, in one variable. See here, this is linear inequality containing only one variable x. Linear inequality containing only one variable x. This is linear inequality containing only x. Linear inequality in one variable. Solution of linear inequality, that means set of numbers for which this statement is true. So here in this chapter we are discussing about solution set of these linear inequalities. See, you did method to find a solution of linear equality. As for example, if you are asked to solve, suppose here if I pick 2x plus 7 equal to 15. So this is linear equality. Now its solution. Its solution is 2x equal to 8, so x equal to 4. So solution, x equal to 4 is a solution. Only one number, it is 4, which satisfies this equation. So this is said to be its a solution. X equal to 4, if you keep here, 4 into 2, 8, 8 plus 7 is 15. So value of LHS is 50, RHS is also 15. So LHS equal to RHS for x equal to 4. So this equation is satisfied, therefore this is said to be solution. So whenever we solve linear equation in single variable, this is equation, then its a solution will be a single number. But here we have inequality. So see, method to solve this equation, minus 12x is more than 30. We want to know about values of x. Which values of x, for which values of x this statement is true. That we want to know. So here, what we do, implies. Now, minus 12x is more than 30. First of all, I change sign on both sides. Changing sign on both sides, 12x, this side minus 30. So what I have done? Changing sign on both sides, that means this is multiplied by minus 1. And when we multiply by negative number, this relation will be changed. So whenever you change sign on both sides, that means it is nothing but you are multiplying by minus 1. So relation will be reversed. Then next, implies. Now divide by 12. Now 12 is positive. So divide by 12, that means you are multiplying by 1 by 12. Multiplying by 1 by 12. 1 by 12 is positive. So when multiplying by positive, relation will be unchanged. So x less than minus 30 by 12. Relation remains unchanged because multiplied by 1 by 12. Multiplying by 1 by 12 means divided by 12. So keep remember, to any inequality, both sides, if you multiply by positive or divide by positive, relation remains unchanged. So this is what x less than minus, this will be 5 into 6, 30, 2 into 6, 12. So that is x less than minus 2.5. So meaning of this statement is that all x less than minus 2.5 will satisfy this inequality. You can also keep your double implies. If this is true, then this is true. Implies this is true. Implies this is true. So here we can join these statements by sign of double implication. Means a converse is also true. So here, if we show these numbers on number line, this is number line. On number line, somewhere here, suppose minus 2.5, minus 2.5, show on number line, x less than minus 2.5. Here sign of equality is not given. So exclude minus 2.5. Don't take equal to minus 2.5. Take all those numbers which are on left side of minus 2.5. These numbers are less than minus 2.5. But among these numbers, we need x, a natural number. So which are natural on left side of minus 2.5? On left side of minus 2.5, say here is minus 3, here is minus 4, minus 5, minus 6, here is minus 2. Between minus 2 and minus 3, there is minus 2.5. Then here next is minus 1, 0, 1, 2, 3, 4. Naturals are 1, 2, 3, 4, which are on this side. But we require those numbers less than minus 2.5. So less than minus 2.5, there is no any natural. Take only numbers which are less than minus 2.5. So x is a natural number, not possible less than minus 2.5. So answer of this first statement is that there is no any natural. Less than minus 2.5. So solution set in case 1 is empty. So in this case, solution set is empty. So in this case, solution set is empty. Now second, x is an integer. X integer less than minus 2.5. So less than minus 2.5, which are integers? So less than minus 2.5, minus 3, minus 4, minus 5, minus 6, these are integers. So solution set, if x is an integer, if x is an integer, then solution set is x integer less than minus 2.5. So these numbers minus 3, comma minus 4, comma minus 5, comma minus 6, and so on. Negative integer. positives except minus 1 and minus 2. So this is infinite set, not finite. All these negative integers are satisfying this condition. Similarly, in this question, see here, 3x plus 8 more than 2. We want to know about x. So double implies 3x is, now shift 8 on that side. So greater than 2 minus 8 minus 6. That is allowed on both sides in inequality. If you add positive or if you add negative, the relation remains unchanged. If x less than y, then x plus a less than y plus a, adding a on both the sides, whether a is positive or negative, relation remains unchanged. So in short, 8 is shifted on this side. So 2 minus 8 is minus 6. Or this can be spoken as also subtracting 8 on both sides. From left side 8 is subtracted, from right side 8 is subtracted. That means adding minus 8 on both sides. So these statements are same. Adding minus 8 on both sides, or subtract 8 on both sides, or shift 8 on other side. So it will be then minus 8. So minus 6. Now we want to remove this 3. 3 is positive. So dividing by 3, because 3 is positive, sign of inequality remains unchanged. 3 is positive, though inequality remains unchanged. So now we need those numbers which are more than minus 2. So solution for this equation or for this inequality, solution set containing only integers that we need and all reals that we need. So putting this number on a real line, this is real line. Suppose minus 2 is somewhere here. Minus 2, keep minus 2. Here sign of equality is not given. So keep that. Now greater than minus 2, I am putting minus 2 slightly on left side. This is minus 2. Now, if x is an integer, if x is an integer, then solution set is x is an integer such that x is more than minus 2. So more than minus 2, which are integers on this number line? So more than minus 2 means on right side. So which are those integers more than minus 2? So here minus 1, 0, 1, 2 and so on. So minus 1, 0, 1, 2, so on. So integers are minus 1, 0, 1, 2, 3, up to infinity. These are integers more than minus 2. So on number line, take all integers which are on the right side of minus 2, excluding minus 2, because minus here sign of equality is not given. If sign of equality is given, then you have to include minus 2 also. But because sign of equality is not given, except minus 2, take from next. So these are integers. This is the solution set containing integers satisfying the same question. If x is a real number, then solution set is this. X more than minus 2, x is any real. So more than minus 2, any real, that means all these numbers which are on the right side to minus 2, take all of real numbers. So that means this is interval beginning from minus 2. All the real numbers on right side of minus 2. So this is which interval? It is set of all x. Set of all x such that x is more than minus 2. X belongs to R. And its interval form is open interval minus 2 up to infinity. Sign of equality is not given. So after minus 2 numbers are starting. So open interval minus 2 up to infinity. So this interval includes all these numbers, whether it is rational or irrational. And here these are only integers. So whenever you need solution set as a set of real numbers, take everything, rational, irrational, satisfy this condition. So it can be such interval. Now here, solve for real number, real solution. Here also we can give sign of equality. Now here, implies simplifying this in equation, both sides, we are simplifying terms. 3x minus 3 less than or equal to 2x minus 6. Then terms containing x we collect on left side and constant terms we collect on right side. So see, these are terms containing x. So 2x I am taking on this side. So 3x keep as it is, 2x keep on this side. So minus 2x less than or equal to minus 3 I am shifting on this side. So it will be plus 3 and minus 6 as it is. That is 3x minus 2x is x less than or equal to 3 minus 6 is minus 3. So solution for this inequality is set of all numbers which are less than or equal to minus 3. So it's this solution set we can also represent on double line. Its picture represents of this solution set showing on number line. This is number line. Somewhere here there is minus 3. Now I keep this slightly on right side, minus 3. Now we need all x which are less than or equal to minus 3. So because sign of equality is given, include minus 3. X equal to minus 3 and all numbers which are less than minus 3. So take these all numbers. This side there are negative numbers up to minus infinity. This part we can show dotted part. Similarly in this diagram, this part which is unwanted, it can be shown as dotted part. So these are all numbers which are less than minus 3 as well as equal to minus 3. See, this is filled. In this question, sign of equality also not given. So this is blank. Minus 2 is not included. This is blank. This is filled. So here, solution set. If x is real, then solution set is, it is set of all x such that x is less than or equal to minus 3, x belongs to R. Real means x belongs to R. And its internal form, you can easily write on from this diagram, it is minus infinity to minus 3, because sign of equality is given. So keep close. If you are asked, solution set where x is an integer, so take only integers, which are integers on left side, minus 4, minus 5, minus 6. So keep minus 4, minus 5, minus 6. Show these numbers in set. So if x is integer, so it is set of these integers. But here x is real, so includes all numbers, rational, irrational, everything satisfying this condition. So here, because all statements conversely also true, we can join these statements by sign of double implication. Now here, solve for real x. In this equation, these numbers are in denominator. For to solve this easily, to make calculation easy, what we do? We remove these numbers which are in denominator. For which what we do? Here, on the left side, numbers in denominator are 2 and 3. LCM of 2 and 3 is 6. So multiply this inequation by 6. So numbers in denominator will be removed. So multiplying by 6, so this will be 6x plus multiplying by 6, 3x, multiplying by 6, 2x, 6 into x, 5 into 2x, here multiplying by 6, less than, this is multiplied by 6, don't forget to multiply right hand side, 6, every number is multiplied by 6, so these 2 and 3 are removed. Implies 6 plus 3, 9, 9 plus 2, 11x. Less than 66. Now we want to remove this 11. 11 is positive. So dividing by 11, it will be 6. 66 by 11, 6. Sign of inequality remains unchanged. And conversely, also these statements are true. So here, this is sign of double implication, it is not sign of equality. You are not allowed to keep your such sign of equality. This is wrong. Don't join these statements by sign of equality. This is double implication. It's different. So here, if x is real, showing this on number line, somewhere here, I get 6. Now x is not equal to 6, so keep deleted. 6. Less than 6, so these numbers are less than 6 of 2 minus 3, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1, 0, minus 1, this side. So if x is real, then solution set is, equal to set of all x such that x less than 6, x real, and its integral form is open minus infinity to 6. 6 is not included, so keep open. So this is the set of all these real numbers. These are unwanted numbers. So showing by dotted line. So this is the method to find solution of these inequalities. Solution set means from this interval, if you select any number and substitute value of that number here, LHS will be less than RHS. But if you select any number from this side, this is not part of solution set. As for example, on this side, somewhere there will be 12. 12 is not a solution. If you take x equal to 12, and if you keep here 12, then see what happens. Put 12. So 12 plus 12 by 2 is 6, plus 12 by 3 is 4. Now make total. 12 plus 6, 18. 18 plus 4, 22. So value of left hand side will be 22 for x equal to 12, while right hand side is 11. So 22 less than 11 is not true. So for x equal to 12, this is false. So 12 is not the solution. But if you select any number on this side, statement will be always true. Selecting any number from this interval, this is true. So set of those numbers satisfying any equation is said to be solution set. So this is solution set. That is meaning of solution set. So this set contains infinite numbers.